Shukran, Sayyid al-Rais.
Thank you, Chairperson.
Señor Presidente, Excelencias,
Chairperson, Excellencies, distinguished delegates,
tengo el honor I have the honor to deliver this statement
on behalf of the Bolivarian Republic of Venezuela.
Mi país,
my country, as a member state of the non-aligned movement,
China
fully subscribes to the declaration that I had the honor to deliver yesterday on behalf of our movement.
On this item,
I would like to highlight some elements and refer further on to some of the issues on our agenda.
So I shall depart a little
from the text which is being distributed, and I crave the understanding of the interpreters. This being said, I wish on behalf of the Bolivarian Republic of Venezuela to welcome you, Ambassador Abdel Wahab Beluki of Morocco, as the Chairperson of the 22nd session of the Conference of the States Parties, and express our confidence in your able leadership to steer this conference to a successful conclusion. We would also like to express our appreciation to the Director General, Ambassador Ahmed Mzunju, for his informative and comprehensive report delivered at the start of this session, and appreciate his continued efforts and those of his team in the Technical Secretariat to promote further the role of the organization in the international disarmament regime and to carry out your functions under the convention.
Venezuela continues to underline that the use of chemical weapons and
toxic chemicals as a weapon anywhere by anyone and in any circumstances is reprehensible and completely contrary to the provisions of the Convention and the legal norms and standards of the international community. We also reaffirm that those responsible for the use of chemical weapons must be held accountable. Venezuela expresses its deep concern regarding the attempt to accuse states parties of using chemical weapons on the basis of unsubstantiated allegations made by media reports or other open sources, including non-governmental entities. This trend may set a dangerous precedent in the future work of the OPCW. As regards the elimination and destruction of the chemical weapons stockpiles in Syria and the destruction of the Syrian chemical weapons production facilities, Venezuela welcomes the substantive efforts made and progress achieved in this regard.
We
encourage the continuation of successful cooperation between the OPCW and the Syrian Arab Republic on all these issues. Chairperson,
Venezuela
congratulates the Russian Federation on its full destruction of its chemical weapons stockpile under OPCW verification. This is undoubtedly a major achievement for the entire international community. Venezuela also congratulates Ambassador Arias for having been unanimously recommended by the Executive Council for the post of Director General of the Technical Secretariat of the OPCW. We would also like to express our sincere gratitude to the other six candidates for their spirit of flexibility, which led to consensus and the successful completion of this process. We also appreciate the role of the Chairperson of the Executive Council, Ambassador Sheikh Mohammed Bilal of Bangladesh, for leading this process in an open, transparent manner.
Chairperson,
my delegation wishes to refer to the forthcoming elections of the members of the Executive Council during this 22nd session of the Conference of the State Parties to be held tomorrow, as provided for
in
the agenda which was adopted at the start of this conference. The government of the Bolivarian Republic of Venezuela has submitted its candidacy for one of the four electoral seats for our regional group. as a member of the Executive Council for the period 2018-2020. This Venezuelan nomination is based on the principles of rotation, which enshrines the right of each state party to serve as member of the Executive Council. This organization, in accordance with paragraph 23 of Article 8 of the Convention, Venezuela is a proud member of the non-aligned movement in China and currently has the honor, as I pointed out, to serve as its chair. Our country wishes to continue with the tradition of our predecessors that have served as members of the Executive Council while leading our non-aligned movement. My country is one of the great contributors to the organization and the fourth contributor in Latin America and the Caribbean. This highlights the prominence of its chemical industry. Furthermore, our country is the first in the region to have a permanent mission accredited exclusively to the OPCW, which emphasizes the importance our country attaches to multilateralism in general and to this organization in particular. Venezuela had the honor to be a member of the Executive Council for a single term from 1998 to 2000, since when it has not been a member of this important body. Nonetheless, it has supported the countries of our region through consensus who have occupied the seats throughout the more recent years. That is why we inform you that other countries have been members: Peru for 29, Chile for 12 years, Guatemala for 6 years, and Panama for 10 years. Nonetheless, regrettably, at present, it has not been possible to achieve a consensus inside our regional group owing to the interference of a country outside our region for political reasons expressed through the so-called Lima group. Regrettably, after 3 months of meetings, it has not been possible to achieve consensus in our regional group owing to this foreign political interference brought into our group by some members of it. A group of countries in our region, including candidates for the seating, and a country from outside the region, met in August of this year to agree on a political statement known as the Lima Declaration, where they took the countries not to support any Venezuelan candidacy put forward to regional and international organizations and any of their mechanisms. This is information which you can see in any of the websites of the various countries of this Lima group. This is the reason for the lack of agreement in our region, and the reason why my country has felt necessary to come to this conference to request for a vote under Rule 79 of the Rules of Procedure of the Conference, since this is the only body for resolving this conflict which affects our regional group, given the impossibility of achieving an agreement which respects the right of rotation enshrined in the Convention. Any initiative for dialogue will be hampered by the political methods imposed, which is a distraction. As a result, there is and will be no agreement when there are vetoes on political grounds to oppose our country, seeking to overwhelm this organization, ignoring its technical nature. For 4 weeks now, Venezuela has been calling for the coordinators of our group to report to this conference that there is no agreement regarding nominations for the Executive Council, but all of these requests have been disregarded. That is why we have no option but to address this august conference directly. we should point out that the coordination of our regional group belongs to a country which has also signed the Lima Declaration and which is, of course, also a candidate for a post on the Executive Council. With this in mind, I have to emphasize that it's not our country which has broken the principle of reciprocity. It is not our country that has taken an inflexible stand. It is never asked who has not exercised a right that remains outside, that shows flexibility. It seems more logical that those who have exercised this right for many years and continuously, as has happened here, should step aside so that those who have not been able to exercise this right may do so. We wish to restate our request for all the rules to be upheld, which will allow for the active mechanism provided for under Rule 79 of the Rules of Procedure of the Conference, so that we proceed to elect the members of the Executive Council by voting without any further delay, as provided for under the agenda item scheduled for tomorrow. The 29th of November. Lastly, Venezuela reaffirms the need to uphold the principles set forth in the Convention and calls on all states parties not to polarize or politicize the work of the organization. We encourage all the states parties to work hand in hand to achieve consensus and the successful conclusion of this session. I would like this statement to be dealt with as an official document of the 22nd session of the Conference of the State Parties, and would call for it to be placed on the website of the organization. Thank you for your kind attention.